Firstly, let us discuss what is interface. An interface specifies what a class must do and not how it does. Interfaces are syntactically similar to classes, but they lack instance variables and their methods are declared without any body. The general form of an interface is interface, which is a keyword, then interface name, methods with their return type, and variables which are final. An interface is by default abstract. Member variables are by default public, static, and final. Member methods are by default public and abstract. By abstract, we mean the body is not defined. By final, we mean their value cannot be changed. And by static, we mean that they are called by name of the class. And here in this case, name of the interface. Now, let us see the implementation of interface. Once an interface has been defined, one or more classes can implement that interface. To implement an interface, we include the implements clause in our class definition. The general form of an interface is XSpecify, which may either be public or not used, class keyword, class name, which implements our interface. If we are extending a superclass, then we use extends and the name of the superclass, then implements, which is a keyword, and all the interfaces which we need to implement. Now, let us consider an example. Here, A1 is an interface. Interface is by default public and abstract. Float pi is equal to 3.141f. We have used f because it is a float variable. Member variables of an interface are public, static, and final. Void m1 is a member method. It is public and abstract. Since it is abstract, its body is not defined here. Now, we have a class named interface, which is implementing the interface A1. We have defined the body of M1 in this class. We have another member method display which will access member variable of the interface. We can see that member variable of an interface is accessed by the name of an interface A1.py. We must keep in mind that we cannot create an object of an abstract class. Since interface is an abstract class, we cannot make an object. We have accessed M1 of interface A1 through an object of class interface. Now let me run this program. I can see in output implementation of interface, which was there in M1 method, and accessing member variables of interface and value 3.141, which was there in display method. We have seen an example of interface. Now let us see various form of interface inheritance. We have single level inheritance, multi-level interface inheritance, hierarchical interface inheritance, and hybrid interface inheritance. Multiple inheritance is allowed with interface, but as we saw earlier, it is not allowed with classes. This was all about interface. Thank you everyone. See you soon in our next video.